Get ready to match the star. Dick Gaudier, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, Marianne Lovely, Richard Dawson, and Eddie White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Ravers!
Thank you, Johnny Olsen.
Thank you.
Just got one little quick thing I want to say, and then we'll press on and say, look, Mr. Dawson brought a review in my dressing room, one I hadn't seen, of a play that Charles Nelson Reilly directed, and you really got great bouquets, expertly directed, and we congratulate you, Charles.
That's good. Donald
Banhurst. Yeah, the Rex Reed thing was marvelous, too, yes. Charles is getting all kinds of accolades for The Belle of Amherst, a marvelous show starring Julie Harris. Now, let's say hello to Kay Denny and Dinesha Ellsworth. I forgot how much money you won. How much money do you want?
$600.
Yes. Okay. Kay, now you're a student, right?
No, my husband's a student.
Oh, your husband's a student.
Yes.
I knew one of you was a student. You look studious yourself.
And we're from Dallas, Texas.
And you're from Dallas, Texas.
Can't leave that out.
Right. You don't want to leave that out. Now, we've had our first round question for both of these ladies, and neither one of them has matched our celebrities. But remember, the first round ones are tough. The ones coming up, the second round, you're going to find easy. It's going to be a breeze for you. And we'll go to round two right after we go to this.
Your doxy.
Okay. Here we go. We'll plow on here. A or B, Dinesha?
B, please.
B? Now, since no one was matching the first round, everybody plays. Dr. Bitem the Dentist...
Oh, golly, that hurts.
...has invented a new technique for removing all your teeth at once. He uses a blank.
I don't even understand that question.
Dr. Bitem the Dentist invented a new technique. He removes all your teeth at once. He uses a blank.
He uses a blank?
Right. Very good. She got a good one.
It's in there.
Yeah, good. Good.
Cooking away.
All right. All right, everybody ready there? You know, this has never happened in the history of Match Game. Dawson is last.
Oh. Does that thrill me?
Dawson was last on that question. Oh. That's never happened.
I just wanted to see what it felt like. Nothing to it.
Nothing to it at all. All right, Dinesha. Dr. Bitem the Dentist has invented a new technique for removing all your teeth at once. He uses a blank.
His fist.
His fist. His fist, she says.
I said he uses a hammer. Just...
Oh, that may be a little more efficacious than a fist.
No, I didn't understand that question at first, but now I really feel I have the definitive answer for it. Because it makes it simple. With a hammer, you could miss a few. I said he used a stick of dynamite. Just stuck it.
Wow.
Thank you.
Yes, you could lose your head over that, yes. Charles?
I know why Richard took the longest.
Why?
Because he's the only one that doesn't have his own teeth, and he was writing from experience.
Let a hammer... Oh, got very breezy down here. Betty, you rascal. Dr. Bitem the Dentist has invented a new technique for removing all your teeth at once. He uses a...
Well, I said a big hammer. And
a big hammer. Poing! That'll do it.
And there are chiclets everywhere.
Right. What do you say, Richard?
I'm going to appeal to the judges. She said a fist, and I said a fighter. That's a
fighting...
You know, a fist for it.
come, come a step up.
Yeah, go ahead. Come on here.
Come on out here and tell me that face to face.
Show him how you hit him. Show him how. Show.
Oh! I'm really cross, because that's exactly why I would bring a fighter.
What would a fighter do? Kick him to death?
Yeah. Well, some of the fighters I fought with, all those rounds went on.
Clinching, yes, Betty.
Richard won the Golden Gloves, and they came clear up to him. Since I'm on Richard's side, I really think that was a match, because you know how those fighters are in the clenches. Clench fist.
Clench fist, yes.
Oh, delicious.
So, that's one for you. Now we go to you, Kay. It appears like smooth sailing, but you never know. Dumb Doris, oh dumb.
How bloody dumb is she, my darling?
Let me tell you, when the man at the service station told her that her tires were getting bald, she put blank on them. That's how dumb she is. Kay Denny. Kay Dumb Doris, so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'll tell you how dumb she is. When the man at the service station told her that her tires were getting bald, she put blank on them.
Hair.
Hair. Hey, little lady says you put hair on the bald tires.
Well, I said, well, this is close. Hey, judges, hey, look, hair grow on them. Same
hair
thing,
grow.
Right?
Hair grow. Oh. But it's a good answer. Brett?
I believe that there will be no discussion or booing or anything except a loud, clear bell tone. Toupees.
Toupees. One for Kay. At this moment, the score is tied. Charles, one more hair piece will win the game for her.
Take it off!
Take it off. Leave him alone.
I would like to publicly resign from a major daytime show. First of all, I don't understand, Auntie Brett, what a toupee is.
Yeah, right.
But a wig, I know.
Yeah.
So that wig is on. What a rough you have there. Hair, hair, hair. Two more hairs down there. That's right. Okay.
It's a pleasure meeting you, my dear.
To be in here.
Thank you, Dionysia. Dionysia Ellsworth, we've got gifts for you to get a lesson.
Okay,
goodbye.
Bye.
Now, while she's spinning off, we're going to send some messages especially for you.
Where is the little bastard?
Here we are. Kay Denny here has won her second game. She right at this moment has $700, but she could win over
$700.
Yeah, you had $600, and then you picked up another $100 when you just won this game.
It's
so
fine. Y'all can give me as much as you.
You're going to have to earn some of this, Kay.
Okay.
All right, shall we plow? You could win another $5,000 here. Let's see what happens. We polled a studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Rum blank. And the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. $250 for you if you match the middle one, and $100 if you match the bottom one. And who's going to help?
I'll take Richard.
Rum and Coke.
Rum and Coke. Okay,
thank you. And Betty?
Betty, have you got one?
Rum Baba.
Rum what?
No, I didn't know. Well, I did rum
Baba rum?
It's a dance.
Yeah. Well, that's it. Oh,
well,
that's...
No, not really. Yes, rum for your life.
Rum, no. Rum,
I gave you rum and Coca-Cola, and I'm out of rum.
Yes. I don't drink. Don't
All
get
right.
me involved.
Rum, rum Baba is hers. Choose one more.
And Brett.
You're going to be very surprised. I have one. What about rum cake?
Rum cake.
Yeah.
Brett would know about such things, naturally. So you've got rum cake, rum baba, and rum and coke.
I'll take cake.
You'll take the rum cake.
Did you let the audience influence you,
Matt? Yes, everything.
Now, she chose Rum Cake because you screamed and cheered and whistled and hollered when Rum Cake came up there. Now, if you're wrong, she's going to come down there and ping you in the nose, each one at a time there. Okay, Kay. Rum Cake is what we want. Let's find out if we got a little Rum Cake up there. May we see the $100 response? Rum Dum. I knew him well. Okay, let's see if we got a little Rum Cake under the $250 response. Rum Cake, congratulations. You got another $250. So that means, Kay Denny, you have a total of $950 at this moment, and you're going to play for 10 times the $250 or $2,500. Before we go on there, let's see what's under the $500 response. Rum and Coke.
Oh, ye of little faith.
That's right. She probably would have picked Rum and Coke if the audience hadn't influenced her, so you owe her a lot of money, and you're not getting out of this studio until you pay up. Johnny, you figure it out on a pro rata basis. What it'd be, it's about $12 a piece that you owe, so. Yeah. Now, you got to match one celebrity exactly to get the $2,500, and you have to choose one.
I'll try Richard again.
Okay, Richard, you're on again. Let's see if it works this time. Are you thinking about Richard?
I'm thinking.
What's that? What are you thinking about, Richard?
I better not say.
Oh. Well. Shall we go on with the game? All right, here it is. It's worth $2,500. Blank and go. Blank and go. All right, Kay, he made up his mind very quickly. Let's see what you do with this. Blank and go.
Up and go.
Up and go. All right. She says, up and go will match you. What do you say to that, Richard?
I'm in shock, Kay. Where do you get these answers?
From this man at the bar.
Well, when I gave you Rum and Coke, at least you would have had $500.
Yes.
And then somewhere out of the air, hit up and go. Stop and go.
Stop and go. Was that an impulsive answer?
Anything.
You just couldn't think of anything?
Have you ever had to do this before?
No. You've got to really concentrate, because I try and send
that's right.
Waves
he's got
to
a
you,
lot of
so if you're blank,
ESP
just
in his
concentrate.
That's right, exactly. Charles, what are you doing?
This is a scandal sheet. It says Betty White, 29, the Hollywood actress, has left her longtime husband, Alan Ludden, to marry this king of a native island. She and Rumbaba will be married...
Okay, you've got your $950, and if you're ready, let's bring on another challenger. Here comes Kim Ketchum.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Great.
Yes, I'm glad to hear you're great, Kim. Where are you from?
I'm from Hinesburg, Vermont.
Hinesburg?
Right.
I know Vermont very well. Hinesburg. Now, don't tell me. Hinesburg. Where is that?
Up near Burlington.
Near Burlington.
Near, right.
Oh, yeah, I'm not too familiar with that area.
Right.
I know Sugar Bush and all those areas.
I'm a skier.
You are?
I spent my winters skiing in Aspen, Colorado.
Oh, no kidding.
No, it's great.
Yeah.
Great.
Super. It's a great sport.
Yep. And I'm also a... braider. Spend my summers braiding horses' manes and tails at horse shows.
So, what do you do then? Various horse shows?
At hunter and jumper shows.
Yeah.
In the East Coast.
Yeah.
I go all over the East and...
Really?
Right.
And you braid horses' tails?
Yeah.
What's the matter with that?
There's nothing wrong with that.
It gets messy now and then.
Yes,
one way of looking at it.
Do they ever kick? I mean, is it dangerous?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to be careful,
no,
don't
man.
You? I mean, they don't like it too much, do they?
Most of them, it doesn't bother.
Oh, it doesn't bother them, yeah. Well, Kim, we wish you the best of luck. We're going to start this game in 1 or 2 minutes, right after we do a little business with America. Here we are. We're ready. Got a new player. Got some new questions. Brand new game here. Kim, it's your choice, A or B.
I'll take A.
A? All right. Good luck to both players. Are you ready?
I am.
Hello.
Hey, I've got a TV guide listing for you.
Oh, good. Something new?
Monday night, CBS, All in the Family. And, the plot synopsis says, Archie Bunker goes nuts and joins the blank.
Oh, my God!
Archie Bunker goes nuts and joins the blank.
Oh, that's good. I like you.
Archie Bunker goes nuts and joins the...
Okay.
Charles is falling asleep again.
Yes. You know who Archie Bunker is, don't you?
No, he doesn't.
All right, now wait, leave him alone. Let's just not...
If you leave him alone, he'll never answer, yes. Sweetheart.
Yes. Anything you want to plug while he's doing it?
Sure.
You've got a movie coming up.
Got a movie coming out called Dick and Jane with George Siegel and Jane Fonda.
Okay.
Comedy. Yeah. Interesting type of thing.
All right. Now, Kim Ketchum. TV Guide listing Monday night. All in the Family on CBS. Archie Bunker goes nuts and joins the...
Well, he really went nuts and joined the gay liberation movement.
Yeah! That's an excellent answer.
I didn't say that, though. I said Archie goes nuts and joins the NAACP.
That's another good one there. That really would be out of character for Mr. Bunker.
Oh, and how? Listen, I think that is an excellent answer, too.
Yeah.
But I didn't say that. I said he joined the Communist Party.
That's another good answer.
There's not so many
more good answers here than I ever realized there were. What do you say?
I didn't come up with one. Yes.
Where are you going, Charles?
That's for the mail we're going to get on this question. Join the circus.
Join the circus.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right in here, lady.
Okay. Marianne Mobley, Archie
yes.
Bunker goes nuts and joins the... What do you say?
Yeah, well, about those good answers.
Oh, are we coming? Are we going downhill from
yeah,
here?
Yeah, we're
on?
Going downhill from yeah. the gay liberation. I said the Marines.
The Marines. Well, that would be out of character.
He would join you, dummy.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He would join the Marines. What do you say, Richard?
I said the NAACP.
CE, yeah. Okay.
And you're very happy.
He loved him.
I hate to let a fellow animal person down.
Right.
Who braids horses' tails and gets such a kick out of his work. But I said that being another animal person, he went nuts and joined the squirrels. And I don't think it's that bad.
Join the squirrels.
I know. I really do. Yeah, I'm sorry.
All right. Here we go. Kay, this is your first round question. It reads as follows. Hey.
Hey.
You hear about Alice the astronaut?
No.
No. Yeah, let me tell you about her.
Okay.
She had her first blink on the moon. Alice the astronaut, she had her first blink on the moon. Oops. Just stretching my legs a little bit. It's nice. I got a little more room to walk here. Never used to have any room to walk. Now I can pace up and down here. And get nervous. All right, everybody ready, Kay Getty? Did you hear about Alice the astronaut? You did. She had her first blank on the moon. What do you say to that?
Affair.
Her first affair on the moon. All right, Dick. Had her first affair on the moon.
But it was all in slow motion. It lasted longer that way.
I said affair on the moon.
Affair on the moon.
Okay. Well, I sort of said affair. I said she had her first bit of whoopee.
Bit of whoopee?
Okay, that's one.
What, again? Are you expecting?
No, but I'm going to get a little on this one, too.
Oh.
It was a rough landing.
Yes.
She had her first miscarriage.
Oh. Boy, what do you say about Alice the astronaut there, Marianne?
Well, she'd been so busy training,
yes.
you know, for this moon program, that she really hadn't gotten around to dating. So oh. she had her first date.
Her first date on the moon, okay.
So this is pretty cushious.
Had her first date on the moon. That's what she says. Richard, what do you say?
Oh, what a lovely story. I said she had her first baby on
her
the moon.
Her first baby on the moon.
Moonbeam. Named a Moonbeam. What do
yes,
you say?
For lunar landing. No, yeah. You wouldn't buy squirrels, her first squirrels on the moon.
No, I wouldn't buy that at all.
I had her first baby on
her first baby on the moon. That's two for you, and that's the end of round one, and now we've got this message just for you. If I ski, I don't do downhill anymore. I broke my leg in Vermont.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I did. I do cross-country skiing now, but you do that too, don't you?
Yeah, a lot. Yeah,
that's a good sport, isn't
good.
It? Yeah,
super.
Now, listen, we got to stop playing the game here, and we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time when we'll start round two. Is that agreeable with you?
Oh, I guess so.
Splendid. So, join us next time for Match Game 76. Team Raven here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Brooks and Bill Condon production. Stay tuned for Cattletales next over most of these CBS stations.